changes. In 1776, this great nation accepted that armed conflict was the only way to preserve our rights to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. If our founding fathers could only see us now. From Antietam to Amiens, Okinawa to Anchorage,
we have fought. And now, the Red Menace is at our doorstep. Democracy itself is under threat of annihilation. That is why today, July 4th, 2076, 300 years after our great nation began, we gather together to honor the completion of Vault 76. This sprawling underground shelter may have been engineered by Vault-Tec, but it was built by you, the good people of America, so that if the bombs do come, if the end does come, our way of life will endure. But not everyone will be saved. Those chosen to enter this vault must be our best and our brightest. For when the fighting is stopped and the fallout has settled, you must rebuild. Not just walls, not just buildings, but hearts and minds, and ultimately, America itself. So as we stand here today, we pray that the world will know peace. But if that is not our destiny, if war must come, we stand together knowing that here in Vault 76, our future begins.
Forget the day you all entered Vault 76. You come from every walk of life, every race, color, and creed. But you all share one very important trait. You are this country's best and brightest. But more importantly, you'll always be my family. Have been tasked with nothing less than the rebuilding of America. Such a huge responsibility. Just know that Vault-Tec is proud of you. I am proud of you. When you hear this, it means I've been gone for several hours. I've got my own mission out there in Appalachia. This is the Overseer, signing off.
It must be terrifying leaving this warm, secure vault for a hostile wilderness. Teamwork. It's what built America. The camp is instrumental to the rebuilding of America.
Madam, I found this holotape on the Overseer's terminal. Seems you should meet her at her camp, just down the road.
South of Vault 76. I knew this wasn't going to be the Appalachia I remembered, but mutated animals? Haywire bots? No people so far. We have to be ready to rebuild in what I can confirm is hostile territory. Fortunately, Vault Tech was prepared. See this? The cooking station, the stash box, the workbenches, all built with the camp. You need a home base out there. The construction and assembly mobile platform is designed to give you one. Just add resources, planning, and a little elbow grease. When you move your camp, everything you've built is stored, ready to be placed back down in the new area. Use this to establish a foothold whenever you're in unfamiliar territory. I've left my camp behind so you can use it. I know I'm breaking my own advice by not taking it with me. But after seeing Appalachia for myself, I need to make sure every resident of 76 has a safe haven they can start from. I'll make do without it. If it's still standing, the town of Flatwoods is further down this road. Find me there. This is the Overseer, signing off.
Thank you.
town of Flatwoods. My God. There's no one here. The old tavern, the church. People were using them for shelter, but they're gone. Mutations we expected. There's something else. A disease. I was attacked by... Well, it used to be a person.
We call it the Great War now. It's not been long, and things have been rough. Welcome to Survivor Stories. I'm Dasa Ben Ami, a responder. I've been working with the responders for a couple years now. I'm from Charleston originally, so it was easy to join up. What wasn't easy was the work. Rebuilding Appalachia from the rubble while survivors flock to us regularly from all over. So many have come and gone. Their stories untold, their names lost to time. I thought we should preserve this history somehow. I've decided to ask people to record their thoughts, their stories, anything they want to preserve forever. I'll call this series the Survivor Stories. I'll start with me. I was an anthropologist.
I stepped up and I said, I'll build a testing kit to monitor the contamination, and I will teach folks how to properly boil water. And I did. The world is getting better, but slowly. We need to make sure it doesn't relapse, too. It's going to take time and care, that's all. Well, time, care, and science.
If you're here to sign up, just use one of our handy dandy terminals.
Albert Winters here, born and raised in this very town. Met my own church to the responders for their outpost here, and you're welcome. The responders are on a true mission, you see, helping folks through thick and thin, till the heavens open up again and take us all up anyways. When this all happened, I figured like most, it was time. This was the end, but it wasn't, was it? We're still here. At first, I thought it was a mistake, that we was missed, forgotten. Maybe we did some wrongs. Didn't give enough to charity, maybe. Didn't praise his name, even in the worst of times. Maybe thought some things that ought not to have been thought. So I asked him. I asked how? Why? I fought your wars on Earth. I'm ready to fight them up there by your side. Then, in my despair, I saw some survivors eating raw rat carcass behind a dumpster. You ought to cook that first, I warned them. Seemed obvious. We tried but got sick, they said, covered in their own filth. I realized right then and there that I was being tasked. Then on, I built kitchens, cooked good food, fed anyone who walked up with an empty belly. And I was thankful for my task in life. Thankful. Next time hell or high water land in my stoop, I'll be swept clear away with it. But till then, let's share a home-cooked meal together, all right?
here to help. As you can see, I'm in a bit of pickle. Some joker knocked me down and loosened my memory transistor. I can't go on without it, as I'm unable to access the message I need to deliver. It jostled out of my chassis over there, and I cannot replace it myself. Would you do me the favor of gathering it and doing the repair? I can't recall if that's the memory transistor over there, but let's try installing it anyway. I can't be any worse off than I am. Thank you! Now I can remember my task perfectly. Now I can finally deliver this long overdue message. I've gotten quite off track, and I appear to be malfunctioning, but I must deliver that message. If you'd be so kind as to help me get to where I'm going, I am allowed to offer you compensation for your troubles. Come now, I think I know the way. I do hope this message brings joy to its recipient. Better late than never. Soon enough. I find that people appreciate a nice face-to-face message to me. Something. Must be one of my broken sensors. job brings me so much joy. Hello? I come bearing an important question for you. Is your refrigerator running? Perhaps you did not hear me. I asked, is your refrigerator running? Well, my instructions do not say what to do in the event of a negative or a non-existent answer. I was simply told to recommend catching it if it were running. Well, I certainly hope you have no refrigerator troubles. If you're